Good morning, students of class 9. Welcome back to the e-classes now. Let us continue our lesson in history. We are doing pastoralists in the modern world. And we have finished the pastoralists of India. And we are continuing our lesson in pastoralism in Africa. And we have talked about Maasai, about their difficulties and hardships. Now here we have reached pastoralism in Africa 3.3. It is 3.3 here. When pastures dry, during drought, when the rain fails. So when the pastures run dry or all the fodder or grasses, the land itself dries up, what problems they face? Let us see, because they were confined in one area, isolated, so they could not move out. Now here they face the problem. Now let's see. Now there are altogether 4 points over here in this. When rains fail and pastures dry, when the grass dries up, cattle are likely to starve unless they can be moved where grass or fodder is available. Previously, before colonial period, they used to move from one area to another area because that was their tradition, that was their custom, and that's why they are called nomadic by nature, because they keep on moving in search of fodder for their animals. But here, during the colonial period, they were confined in a small area, that to semi-arid regions, and during the drought, when the rains fail. So that is why pastoralists are nomadic. Previously also they used to move around. But when the rain fails and the grasses or the fodder dry up, they find it very, very difficult, and their cattle, they die in large numbers, you can say that. They can be moved. They have to be moved from that dry areas to another area where they could find the grass. But here they could not do the same. Here, large number of Maasai cattle died of starvation. Lack of fodder, lack of grass. During the drought, large number of cattle died due to starvation and disease. Starvation and disease, because the animals get weak, they get sick in the year of drought, especially during the year of drought, when there is no rainfall, when the rain fails. In 1930, let us look at the figures over here. In 1930, Kenya only, there is Tanzania also, but Kenya, we'll talk about Kenya. Kenya possessed 720,000 cattle, Maasai herders and other pastoralists altogether. They had total 720,000 cattle, 820,000 sheep and 171,000 donkeys. These are the number of animals they had, they possessed in 1930. In the previous class I have told you why they kept donkeys. They kept donkeys in order to carry their belongings. They move from one area to another area, that's why they require donkeys to carry their belongings. But now they are confined, they could not move, but still they had the donkeys. Number four, in just 2 years, 1933 and 34, 2 years. In just 2 years, these 2 years they faced drought. 1933, there was a drought. 1934, again drought, right? Simultaneously, one after another. 1933 and 34, over half of the cattle, this number reduced to half. Half of the cattle in the Maasai reserve died due to drought. Half the number died. So this was the figure. If they had the permission to move out from there, their cattle wouldn't have died, but they were not allowed to move out from their areas, so half the number of their cattle died due to starvation and disease because the rain failed. So you can see that this is the when pasture dry, what happens, what problems they face. Now here number 3.4, we are talking about 3.4 now. Not all were equally affected. All were not equally affected. Especially the pastoralists, they were affected. But other people who worked for the colonial government, who worked as farmers, who worked as businessmen, they were not affected much due to drought and so on. But pastoralists, they were severely affected. Here, not all were equally affected. We'll continue on. This paragraph is big. Before this, let's talk about Maasai people, the Maasai tribe, pastoralists. They were divided into two categories, two groups. In pre-colonial times, pre means before, in pre-colonial times, Maasai society was divided into two social categories. Social categories. We are talking about Maasai, but other pastoralists also had the same tradition. Their society was divided into two groups, elders and warriors. Elders and warriors. This the division of the society. The elders form the ruling group. The elders look after the matter. They form rules and regulations. Elders formed the ruling group and met, discuss. They had a meeting. They met often to decide on the affair of the community. Affair means matter. The matter related to their community, they sat together, various groups from various pastoralist groups, they used to head the leader, elders, they used to sit together and discuss the matter of their community and settle disputes. Sometimes dispute arises and they used to sit together and settle dispute. So this was the duty of their elders. Now what about the warriors? Warriors were younger people. Warriors were younger people and their duty is to protect their community or tribe. Why they needed protection? Because various pastoralist group, they used to raid the cattle. They used to go and steal the cattle. So they need to protect their herd. Sometimes the other communities, they come and attack and take the cattle, take away their cattle. So they need to protect and they have to, warrior means fighters. They need to be fighter, a man. So we'll talk about that warriors later on in our next class. So warriors were younger people who protected the tribe from other pastoralists. They used to come and steal their cattle. That's called cattle raid. So to protect their herd from the cattle raid by other communities. So these younger people are generally warriors and they have to prove that they are warriors. So we'll talk about that in our next class. So this much for today. Go through the online portal every day and make a habit. Don't waste your time. I hope you are doing the same. Studying regularly. Be wise enough. Every day I tell you, be wise enough to use your time wisely because time is running out. It doesn't wait for anybody else. So we need to do everything when there is a time. So that's all for today. So hope very soon school will go open, reopened, and we'll have nice classes. In the class, everything will have proper. So anyway, for the time being, you go through the online portal and continue studying at home as well. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you for watching the video.